Hey guys, what's up? Back again for another guitar tutorial. It's been a while, been making some other videos, so subscribe to my channel if you want to see when I upload the latest stuff. We're hopefully gonna be doing some more music tutorials, guitar, piano, maybe some ukulele in the future. So anyways, let's just get to this song. Not too difficult of a song, only really three chords throughout the entire thing, and it never really changes. So the first chord is a G, and if you don't know what a G chord is, basically it's the third fret, so first fret, second fret, third fret, your middle finger on the top string, third fret, and then your index finger on the second string down. That's actually the fifth string up, and so then it's open. Open, when I say open, I just mean you're not holding down any of the strings with any fingers, and then your ring finger on the third fret, second string up, and then your pinky finger on the first string, third fret, right there. So that is G, and that's the first chord you play, and you'll play through twice of that one. I'll show you the strumming pattern in just a second. And then the second chord is not too difficult to switch to. It's an E minor 7 chord, and basically that's open on the top string, meaning pushing down nothing, and then your index finger on the second fret, fifth string. So right there, and then the next string you're holding down is right underneath that, still second fret with your middle finger, and fourth string up, and then open, meaning nothing, and then your ring finger and pinky finger are then in the same position that they were for the G. So right on the third fret there, second string, and first string. So just keeping the same from G to E minor 7. Okay, and then the third and final chord in this song is a F sharp slash D, and all that means is you're holding down F sharp as the sort of the bass note. So with your index finger, second fret over on the top string, you're going to hold down that right there, and then it is open, open, meaning nothing, and then your middle finger on the second fret, third string up. So it's second fret with your index finger, open, open, and then second fret with your middle finger. And then your ring finger still has not moved. It's still on the third fret, second string up. And you can keep your pinky there too if you want to, but usually like an F sharp slash D is not played with the pinky on the third fret. But you can keep it there if you want to, because it doesn't move throughout the entire song. So anyways, the strumming pattern is pretty easy. It's sort of four, strum, like down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So you stay on the G twice through the first part. So it sort of looks like this. Okay, and then it switches to the E minor 7. And you only go through that one time. And then you switch to the F sharp, F sharp slash D. Okay, so it basically looks like this. I'll play through it a couple times. So you notice there's a little palm mute in there. There's some lead going on in the original recording of the song, but if you just want to play it solo acoustically, this is how I guess I would recommend you play it, is just sort of the down, up, 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 just like that. And that'll get you through the whole song. That's the verses, the pre-chorus, the chorus. It's all the same sort of rhythm, and it's basically that down, up, down, up tempo. So hopefully that helps you. Just play along with the song. It should help you get through it, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Check out my other tutorials. On the left, click for Justin Timberlake's Suit and Tie, and on the right, Train Song Mermaid. Don't forget to subscribe, as I will be uploading lots more videos in the very near future. Goodbye.